holy book that has the power to remove all fear and doubt. And this book tells the story of a man who means the world to me. Could just as well have been a woman, except for male head Cherokee. So they call him the Bodhisattva, never disparage, the Bodhisattva, never despise. And I'm making it my life's ambition to see the world through his pure eyes. This is the verse. I will never disparage you or keep you at arm's length. Where you only see your weaknesses, I only see your strength. I would never despise you or put you down any way. Because it's clear to me, I can plainly see, you'll be a Buddha someday. I love you. Now the Bodhisattva, never disparaging, lived countless in the past. In the time of the counterfeit Dharma, and he was something of an outcast. Because the monks and nuns of his time, they were noted for their arrogance and vanity. And these were the folks who exercised great power and authority. But my boy, he never concerned himself if they treated him like a freak. He just bowed to everybody equally, and these are the words he'd speak. Here's the chorus.
I will never disparage you or keep you at arm's length.
Sing it louder. Where you only see your weaknesses,
I only see your strength.
I will never despise you
or put you down in any way.
Because it's clear to me,
I can plainly see, you'll be a Buddha someday. I love you.
Never read or recited the scriptures much. He only liked to practice respect. But the monks and nuns at this time, they didn't treat it like you might expect. Instead, they cursed him, and they reviled him, and they wished that he would go. Because they all had self-esteem issues, like everybody else I know. So they beat him and pelted him with clubs and stones and tried to drive him away. But he just ran off to a safe distance and then turned around and said,
I will never disparage you or keep you at arm's length.
Where you only see your weaknesses,
I only see your strength. I will never despise you or put you down in any way.
Because it's clear to me,
I can plainly see, be a Buddha someday. I love you.
I always say, that's the hardest line for somebody from New York like me to say. And so it went on for years and years. He was the target of scorn and abuse. Still our hero, he shed no tears, nor did he ever wonder what's the use. Until he came to the end of his natural lifespan, he lay down fixing to die. And he heard the Holy Lotus Sutra being preached up in the sky. And his life was extended for millions of years. He's living to this day. And in the pages of the Lotus Sutra, well, you still can hear him say,
I will never disparage you or keep you at arm's length.
Where you only see your weaknesses,
I only see your strength. I will never despise you or put you down in any way.
Because it's clear to me, I can
plainly see, be a Buddha someday.
Yes, it's clear to me,
I can plainly see, be a Buddha someday. I love you. I love you.
And so if I was a real Zen master, I would stop there and I'd go in my room. You would all leave. But instead, I'm going to talk for a while more. So